The Honolulu Police Department continues to investigate the murders in Manoa. Meanwhile, teammates and community members are remembering the children involved. Christy Tamashiro reports.
Those that knew the family tell me they are still in shock over the tragedy.
I could not, like, digest what was happening. I still cannot. I just saw them on Friday.
The local soccer community is among the many that are grieving. Coaches from Inter Ohana FC tell me 10-year-old Nana Oda and 12-year-old Orion Oda were members of the club.
Orion was always, like, funny, making jokes, and always, you know, being the little clown.
Everybody likes to give Orion a hard time because he's very loud, but I think that's the same reason why we all love him. Nana was much quieter, but, you know, her quietness spoke volumes when she did say something. You know, when she likes to give her opinion on things and gets involved, you know, she's having a great time.
I'm told Mother Naoko was always sweet and supported her children. The coaches tell me they just met the oldest daughter, a 17-year-old at Iolani School, and she was interested in pursuing culinary. Manoa Elementary, Sikhs, and Iolani School are all providing counseling for students and teachers. Meanwhile, teammates and parents are coming together to build a memorial at Kapiolani Park, where practices were held in honor of the family.
I was talking to a couple parents earlier today, and I mean, this is much bigger than just soccer, right? I think we're a community, and the kids are getting together. They're all supporting each other.
On Tuesday, detectives returned to the scene with other individuals to collect belongings from the home. Community members also continue to pay their respects to the family. Christy Tamashiro, K22 News, working for Hawaii.